All right, guys. Part of the solution, if you will, of eliminating wind knots and managing the line on your spinning rod is the way it is spooled on to the reel. Now, many of us have the time to take it down to a local retailer and have the retailer put it on. Well, they do the best job because they're going to put it on under tension and it's going to come off a bigger spool where it has less memory and you're not going to have any issues. That's the number one best way. But for those of us that don't have a $1,000 spooling machine and have to do it, you know, manually, there's a few things you need to know. One of them is you're going to need a glove. You want to use a glove to put the line on the spool because you want to create enough tension where it tightly packs on the spool. By reeling it on loosely, by laying the spool down and just reeling it that way, the line's not packed on the spool itself. And if it doesn't pack onto the spool properly and get stacked on there right, the first few casts are going to be very problematic and they're going to lead to, well, wind knots. So I'm going to show you right here how you're going to spool the line on, because I've got a real simple system where I've got a spool put on basically a nail so that I can pull it off the top of the spool, and I'm going to put it on with tension on my Shimano. So first thing I need to do is grab my gloves out, and these are a pair of gloves that are a little bit more hardier. These are Carhartts that I use for working around my yard with firewood and stuff. So, but they've got a good palm in them where I can really hold onto the line and it's not going to burn me. I don't care about them. Just one of those things. You're not going to get away with using sun gloves to do this. You need to have a real pair of gloves. The other thing I've attached to my rod and reel combo is I've tied off to it's like a 16 penny nail that I've put my spool onto. And what I've done is if I were going to lay that spool on the floor and have the line come off counterclockwise, I put it on the nail itself so that the label is faced in, so the line's coming off the top. So I've got everything oriented the way I want, and I've already put some backing on this reel. I put some monofilament backing. I put some 12-pound monofilament backing because I wanted to fill close to half the reel with monofilament backing, because I'm putting a very light braided line on here. This is 8-pound spider wire Invisibraid. And this rod setup for me is what I use to throw Ned rigs. So I wanted the lighter line, so I needed to put on a little bit more backing than normal. Basically, once you're at that point, especially if you're all by yourself, all you're gonna do is grab a hold of that line so that you can keep some tension on it. You know, it sounds like a guitar string. And then I'm just gonna reel it up until I fill the spool within, oh, probably about a 16th of the edge of the spool. Once I'm at that point, I'm fine. What I really like about the Shimano Stratix is they have a long stroke spool and it really lays the line on there nice and even and smooth. And I know it's gonna be less problematic for me when I make those first couple of casts, because what I've always noticed in the past is that it usually takes about 20 or 30 casts to really break the spool in right for you not to have any wind knots right away. After that, then there's other things that you'll have to do to manage line, and we'll talk about that later in the chapter about feathering line and things like that that'll keep you from having, well, wind knots.